to be with you.
Thank you so much. So Dr. Nair, before we begin today's discussion, can we please make a small request to the audience who is watching us today? Please put your questions in the comment section. Dr. Nair will try his best to answer all your queries till the end of the session today. But be a little specific when you're writing your questions, like your age, any specific condition that you're aware of, or if you're in between a fertility journey, please do mention all that. So it'll help Dr. Nair to answer them as appropriately as possible. So with this, Dr. Nair, with your permission, can you please start, sir?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. As we all know, sir, like even now, infertility is considered or is still branded as a women's issue. But as we all know, that male are an equal factor of this fertility equation. So with this, Dr. Nair, it will be really a pleasure to know from you what exactly is male infertility, and if you can help us to know the basic scenario. Over to you, Dr. Nair.
You see, you had given in the introduction itself, one in six couple is suffering from infertility. That amounts to almost 15% of the young couple having infertility. And whenever any couple comes for infertility investigation, we always start with investigation of the wife and the husband at the same time. Husbands are responsible for almost 30% of the infertility problem as such. And in another 20%, they are responsible with the wife and husband together, they are responsible for infertility. So nearly 50% of the patients, the husband is the factor responsible for infertility. And once we say the husband is 50% responsible, how the husbands are responsible? Basically, there has to be sperm production, number one. The sperm has to be transported in the semen, and the semen must contain enough number of sperms, and those sperm must be functional and motile. So this is how the basics of male infertility works. There has to be sperm production, and these sperms has to be transported. Now, when we look at the sperm production, everything is controlled from the mind, the brain. The hormones are produced from the brain, which act on the testes to produce the sperms in the testes. FHS and LH is released from the pituitary. It acts on the testicular cells. The Sertoli cells and Leydig cells produce the sperm production there. And these sperms are being transported via VAS. They are go through the passage, yeah. And finally we are basically ejaculated, and the semen is ejaculated. This is how the things work. Now there can be a fault at any of the point. There can be fault at the brain, there can be fault at the testes, there can be fault in the passage, the VAS and this thing. Or there can be fault at the penis also. There can be a erectile dysfunction, coital dysfunction, all this thing. So this is how we have to investigate the male. Whenever a male come to us for an investigation, we start with basic, the history, the physical examination, the semen analysis, hormone analysis if needed, and there are some specific genetic tests if in some cases it has to be needed, imaging studies like scrotal ultrasound or TRUST whenever it is needed. So this is how we move around when we want to investigate what is the problem with the male. To begin with, a very simple, the history, we check for the infertility history, whether the husband has been married earlier, whether the husband has had a fathered a child earlier on with another woman and with this particular wife, is she not conceiving? What about his history of smoking, alcohol, history of wearing tight underwear, whatever increases this temperature of the testes. All these things you have to ask from the history, and similarly the history of exposure to gonadotoxic pesticides, history of having a repeated chest infection. All these things we have to check from the history, and history can lead us many a time to what is the cause of infertility in that male person. And then accordingly, we go ahead to settle this problem and to go further, how to evaluate further. Like I mentioned, first is the history, then is the physical examination, which may include the examination of the testes, of the penis, and sometimes digital PR examination. Then we may need to do a hormonal evaluation in certain cases when the semen count is less than 10 million per ml. We need to do a hormonal evaluation. Basically, like I mentioned, you have to have a semen analysis, which is the cornerstone of male fertility. This semen analysis we do, it's a very simple test and gives us a lot of information. And for the information of the audience, the semen count has been decreasing over the years. When I was medical student in 91 to 1980, that time when I was MBBS student, we were taught that the semen count was 60 to 120 million per ml. And slowly, slowly, it has come down to 40 million. Then it came down to 20 million. Now, currently, the WHO criteria for normal semen count is 15 million. So, it is a gradual decrease in the semen parameter, the semen count, and even semen motility has also decreased over the years. And I think it is the lifestyle changes which is responsible for all this. In the time of my father, this average semen count was 60 to 80 million. During my time, it has come down to 40 million, my age. During the age of my son, now it has come down to 15 to 20 million. So this is a gradual decrease. And maybe if the decrease continue like this in future, maybe down the line after 20 or 40 years, we may be having a severe oligospermia with men with having only 5 million count and everybody running to freeze the sperm for future use. In fact, many of the people in Europe, many of the families had already started freezing sperms for their future because they don't know what is going to happen 50 years from now or 100 years from now. Men will be having very few sperms. Then from where they will get progeny. So they have freezing sperms, you see. That is something probably it will come up in India also. That large families, they will like to have their own progeny in future. And
so thank you so much, Dr. Nair, for giving us such a wonderful brief of today's discussion that you're going to have. And giving us a basic scenario about male infertility. Now, you have, as you've already mentioned, that as the sperm count in male is gradually decreasing, generation after generation. So, and you also mentioned a bit about the probable causes for this. Can you please help us highlighting more specifically what you mean by the probable causes of this declining sperm count?
Lifestyle changes. It is the stress in the life overall, it is physical stress, mental stress.
Sir, can you speak a little louder?
Physical stress, or it is a mental stress, and there is a smoking, alcohol, the anabolic steroids which are available with the gyms, tight underwear which increases the temperature of testes, and many of the younger generation are on a food supplement. The supplement they are being advised to. So we don't know what all are there. And you see, there was a beautiful film I saw a few years back. I saw this film on BBC. They had found out that in a river in England, the population of fish in a certain stream of the river had decreased. They wanted to check what is the issue. They found out that one of the pollutant from the factory which is pouring in that river and following this discharge from the factory, down the line the fish population has decreased. the founder, they analyzed what the factory is producing. The factory was producing basically a material which is used for making our plastic water bottle. The compound which is being used to make the plastic bottle has a lot of estrogenic properties. So when the fish is drinking or swimming, living in the water with estrogenic properties, the male fish produce, their sperm production decreased. So they were not able to propagate further. And that is how they found out that the plastic bottle which is being used for our water, it has estrogenic properties and it can have effect on the sperm production by the male. So if you go now, I've been visiting Europe since many years. Currently, if you go to Europe, you'll find everybody giving you a small glass bottle to have a glass of water or even beer, only in glass bottle. They are no more running and using this plastic bottle, which we are still using in India. We are running up only after the plastic bottle. We think that in my own house, my refrigerator, the water is kept only in the glass bottle. We don't use plastic bottle.
Right.
So this is how the things can evolve over a period of time, that if you get more exposed to estrogenic properties, your sperm count is going to be decreasing. So that is how it works.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Naya, for giving us such a wonderful example of the movie that you saw. And yes, and definitely a very good takeaway from this statement that Dr. Naya has given, that we need to stop using plastic bottles, and it's always better to, you know, to stop using plastic. Now coming to the next one, it is believed that men's age is not a factor of concern, unlike women, when it comes to the fertility equation. And infertility, as infertility is always understood as a silent thing until and unless a couple is trying to conceive. But can you help our audience to know more about, like, are there any signs or I would kind of, you know, symptoms or that a man should know, and he should be concerned that, you know, he should think about his fertility factor. Are there any kind of signs that they can look out for?
The biological clock is tickling both for male and female. It is not only tickling for females, it is tickling for males also. Generally speaking, we find that a man who is older than 45 to 50 years, the sperm count, the sperm morphology, the characters of the sperm, they change. Anybody who is more than 50 and if you father a child,
Sir, can be a little louder, please.
Any male who is more than 50 years, if he father a child, there are more likely to be more incidences of genetic abnormality in the baby.
Okay.
It is very clear to us. A older male also has a problem. And once you get older, you develop other medical issues. You develop diabetes, you develop hypertension, you have to take medicine for all these things. And all this affect your sperm characters, sperm parameters. So it is very clear. So all male should try to finish their pregnancies, achieving pregnancy definitely by 40 years, not to postpone such. We have seen many news time, we have seen in the newspaper many time. There's somebody who is 70 year old, has fathered a child. Yeah, it comes, you see, it does come that even at 75, somebody can father a child, but that is not the routine. The routine is you should finish your fathering a baby definitely by 40, 45, not later than that. Because after that, you are going to develop more problem with the baby. You are going to have more medical issues with yourself. So that is very clear. You cannot postpone it. The biological clock is both for females and both for men.
And the next one would be like any specific signs or a man of during his 30s or 40s can know or can understand that, you know, he should be concerned.